G'day guys, welcome back to the True Footy YouTube channel. Today I'm joined by a couple of plonkers. You've got the Drewzart and you've got Bush Daddy over here. We're going to be doing something a little different on the channel today. We're going to be playing AFL Edition of Two Truths and One Lie. I'm going to say three facts about the AFL, but one of them is going to be a lie. And how they're going to compete against each other is they've got to guess which one I've said is the lie. If they get it right, they get a point. And if neither of them get it right, then I actually get two points, wasn't it?
Two or three?
I reckon two is fine.
Two more.
Two is fine. Yeah, we'll go with two. And so if I get them to, not guess which one's a lie, I get 2 points. So we'll take turns and I will go first. Boys, the first three facts I've got for you are: Scott West holds the record in the AFL for most club bests and fairests with 7.
I don't know who Scott West is.
In 2008, Geelong broke the record for highest average losing margin in a season. And the third one is, Hawthorn have played multiple grand finals against teams starting with F.
I'm going to go with Scotty West.
Okay, so you're going to say the Scott West one is the lie?
Alright.
Drewzy, what about you?
Oh, I don't know. I'd say Hawthorn have played multiple teams, Fremantle and Fitzroy, in a grand final at some point.
Yeah.
That kicks that one out. Geelong had a good 2007 season. So why would they have the largest losing average margin in 2008? All right, I'll lock in Scott West as well. But, Jesse's going to get 2 points off the bat. Nah, all right, I'll go Geelong, largest losing margin, 2008, just to spice it up.
All right, Scott West does not hold the record for most classic appearances. That was a lie. I've forgotten who
Pendlebury
does
record. Has like 7, I think.
Nah, somebody ahead of that. I can't remember, but Scott West was second. In 2008, Geelong broke the record for highest average losing margin this season with 86. They only lost one game all year, and they lost it by 86 points.
Well, I think I just chose the truth. I'm an idiot.
You did choose the truth. Is that what you're looking for?
Yeah, no, I just completely cooked
just
that.
Forgot the rules. The second one, Michael Tuck has the record in the AFL-VFL history for most premierships as a player with 7. Adam Uze holds an AFL record for consecutive games with 226. And thirdly, there has never been an AFL-VFL player with a surname starting with X.
Where the fuck did you get these from?
You know, I just googled weird AFL facts and I was hoping that you were going to do the same thing because I just clicked the first link.
I'm gonna go Adam Uze as a lie. I think Gaff had a big run of not getting injured and playing a lot.
Yeah, back in the Adam Uze call.
Yeah.
You're both right.
Yeah.
I think he's second. The current record is Jim Steins, his fellow clubman, with 250 or something silly like that.
Steins 8.
The third and final one, guys. Firstly, the Sydney Swans were the first non-Victorian team to win the Wooden Spoon in 1992. Secondly, Gary Rowan and Ken Hinckley are cousins. And thirdly, John Longmire is the only AFL-VFL premiership coach whose last name starts with L.
These are left field as. So John Longmire is the only premiership coach.
Yeah, I'm thinking that's a lie.
With the last letter L? Is that it? What was the second one?
The second one, Gary Rowan and Ken Hinckley are cousins.
That's so weird.
I'd buy that though.
And the third one is the Sydney Swans were the first non-Victorian team to win the Wooden Spoon in 1992.
Yeah, I reckon that's probably true. Far out. That's a toughie. Gary Rowan and Ken Hinckley are cousins. Was that one?
Yeah.
That's a lie.
You think that's a lie?
Yeah,
but what about
lie.
Yourself, Bushlock?
Longmire.
Alright, I get 2 points because the only lie out of that were that the Sydney Swans were the first non-Victorian team to win a Wooden Spoon. It was actually the Brisbane Bears in 1990. I think they won it 1990 and 91, and then Sydney won it 92, 93. I hope that's right because I'm making myself look like an idiot, but it was some interesting fact. And then I think Fitzroy after that. So, there you go. Put down 2 for me, boys.
So, 2-2-1 is the score.
Sweet.
At the moment.
Here's our free set of facts. Patrick Cripps has had more disposals in a game than the Bont. Bont and Cripps have both scored 140 points in Dream Team in their careers at some stage, and they have an identical career high for inside 50s.
Oh, Cripps has had some big games. So was the Bont.
I'm going to say this: the first one is a lie, that the Bont's record for most disposals in a game is higher than Cripps. That's what I'm saying.
Mm. Okay, what are you thinking, Drewzy?
They've both had over 140 in Dream Team for sure. Inside 50s, what was identical?
Yep.
Yeah, I'll go the first one as well. I'll say that's the lie, the first one.
You're both wrong. Patrick Cripps' career high is 39 and Bont's is 37.
Disgusting.
It's the Dream Team was the lie.
Bing bong.
The theme of these facts is clangers. Matt Taberner's career high in clangers is only 7.
Only 7?
Luke Shuey has had double-digit clangers in a game before, and Chris Judd has had double-digit clangers in a game before.
They all sound true.
Tavernan has to have more than, like, 13 in a game, surely.
Yeah, I'm going to say that is the lie. Because good players do attract clangers. Like, Buddy Franklin led the league in clangers the year he won the Coleman and had 100 goals.
I think the lie is that Chris Judd has had more than 10 in a game. I think that's a lie.
You are correct.
Damn. Yes, go!
Damn.
He's only had 8, was Judd's career high, I believe. Shuey's was like 10 or 11.
Matt Tavernan better than Chris Judd, question mark?
Yeah.
Oh, Shuey. Yeah.
Definitely. Bit of Dockers versus Eagles, this one.
Yeah, lovely.
The Dockers have had more efficient disposal than the Eagles this year. Dockers and Eagles are both bottom 4 in the league for behinds kicked this year. And neither team has kicked 100 goals this year.
100 goals? Jeez.
You say 100 goals.
Yeah, oh, neither team's kicked 100 goals total for the season.
Fuck. Well, they're 11 rounds in.
So yeah, averaging like 9 and a bit goals.
Didn't West Coast kick like 12 against... Oh, that doesn't really narrow it down though, does it? I'm going to go to the last one. I don't think either side's kicked 100 goals. Wait, so they have or they haven't?
Haven't. Neither side's kicked 100.
I'm going to say the Eagles have kicked over 100 goals this year.
So you think that's the lie?
Yeah, I think that's the lie.
All right, what do I think the lie is? I think that's the lie as well. I reckon, yeah.
You're both right. The Eagles are dead on 100.
Yes.
Because we kicked 18 against Collingwood, so I thought surely we've made up 82 goals.
You were dead on 100.
That's sick.
Bush 4, Jesse 3, and me 3, and now we're going into the final round.
This is the money making round.
Keep watching because you're about to see Jesse get exposed. This camera's a lot like smoother when you're moving.
Be good for porn and that. Planning on shooting some when I find someone who loves me.
Caden McDonald has more subscribers than North Melbourne had members in 2019. We are currently sitting in Hayden Valentine's old bedroom. Lance Franklin has more Coleman medals than Gary Ablett Sr. Where are we going, boys?
I reckon this is Hayden Valentine's current bedroom.
If you didn't know, we have bought Hayden Valentine's grandparents' old house. He did used to live here. But is this his room?
I'm going to guess no.
Yeah, I'm going to say no as well.
Yeah, this doesn't look like a bedroom.
Yeah, it does.
It's got a fucking fireplace. It's
double doors to the backyard.
Yeah, you've got it.
Yeah, that's sick.
Dan Gorringe kicked a goal a game for Carlton. Josh Kennedy has won the most Ross Glendening / Alan medals. The last minor premiership winner to win the flag was Hawthorn.
That's true.
Have it.
I'm going to say the lie is Kennedy doesn't hold the record for Glendening Alan medals.
Yeah, I reckon that's a lie.
Yep, you got it.
I'm not very good at this. Yeah. Oh, no.
Do you know who is? Double points if you guess who is the record holder.
Is it Paul Hazelby?
Oh, well, you're not going to get the points. But yeah, it is. Oh, my God. You guys actually know your stuff. It's not fair. Chris Mayne is a top 4 Freo all-time goal scorer. Michael Voss won the 1996 Brownlow medal. And Nat Fyfe has more goals for Freo than Jesse Hogan did for Melbourne.
Ooh, that's a good one.
Bit tricky.
Ooh.
I need this to tie with Jesse.
Yeah. But Bush is probably going to win either way.
Yeah, I think Bush has run away with it.
Not really. Jesse's only 1 point behind me. Yeah, stuff up and he gets this right.
True.
I'll go the last one.
I'm going to say Chris Mayne is not a top 4 goal scorer.
Jesse's got it! Yeah! He goes to a tiebreaker and lucky I've done 4.
Oh, no!
So I'm last. I'm out. Jesse and Bush, the true footy boys.
Who is the truest footy? Alright, so the scores are level. Busher and myself are on 6. Drewzy's languishing away in 3rd. So this is a tie break. Drewzy, what do you got for us as a tie break?
So what I've decided to do is you got to guess closest to a number of a stat. So I'm going most... how many goals has Dan Gorringe kicked in his career? Closest to it gets the dub. So, yeah. There you go. Easy as that. Whoever gets closest to the number gets the win for the video. So, here we go. How many goals has he kicked?
36. Counted them myself.
Did you?
Is that actually a guess?
Yeah.
I'll say 28.
28, 36. Jesse wins it!
No!
Kicked 11.
Oh, fuck. That was nowhere near.
Dan Gorringe kicked 36 goals.
Like, horrendously overrated Dan Gorringe.
He's the GOAT, to be fair. But, Jesse, you've won.
What the fuck is that?
Alright guys, you've seen it here first. I am the truest footy that ever footied. This is like the first time I've ever won a competition on here, so I'm a little bit emotional. But thanks for watching. Make sure you go check out manscaped.com. Use the code TRUEFOOTY, all caps, all one word, to get clean shaven balls. And speaking of which, thank you Drewzy for joining us on the channel. Go sub to him.
My balls definitely aren't clean. Thanks for having me.
Oh Drewzy, shave your bloody balls.
Alright, we'll see you later guys.